The PI client applications maintain something called a known servers table that keeps track of, well, what you would normally find here, these lists of PI servers that we normally connect to. Now, occasionally, you will find there is a need to clean up what's in that known servers table. And I'll give you an example of why that might be necessary. I'm going to show you what might happen when I open up a display that was built on a different PI system and then somebody sent it via email to me. Now, when that initially starts up, it says basically this message that WinServe03 is not found. So essentially what happened here is when the user first created this display, he created that pointing to this PI server. Now, that's not a PI server that exists in my environment. If I look at my connections, I don't have that PI server. This display that I've opened up actually has embedded in it the information that we are looking for that server. Now, if that server were in the known servers table, it would be no problem. It would show up in this list of connections. There'd be no problem. If the tags are identical between the two servers, one of the things they can do is add this thing called a server alias, where you basically add an alias that you would use for that WinServe32 that would point to a server that you do have. So in that way, all the displays, you know, all the displays that you open up that have references to this, well, those displays will continue to work. They'll just point to a different server. It's kind of rare when people can do that because it's usually only in test environments or training environments that you see PI systems that have duplicate tags. Anyway, to make a long story short, all the activity that you may have in getting different displays from different systems to work, you know, all the things that you may add in this aliases list, those things sometimes are things that you'd simply like to clean out of your known servers table. And we have an application that will do that for you. If you go into Program Files, PI-PC, under the PI-SDK directory, you'll find an application called About PI-SDK. Now, I've already launched it. Here it is. One of the tools available is this thing called Cleanup Connections. What Cleanup Connections does, it's going to, first of all, remove any servers or server entries for localhost. This 127.0.0.1 and localhost originally were part of the original ship of the PI clients. We've decided we moved on to not including those as the default or as a default included server. When we do remove those from the service table, though, we will create an alias just in case there's anything that's pointing to that, so that those displays will not break. Also, we will remove any orphaned aliases. Now, this would be an alias in which that's been created previously, but then for some reason in the known servers table, that alias doesn't exist anymore, or a pointer to the server referred to by that alias doesn't exist anymore. And then finally, we'll just simply resolve anything we can't connect to. So I'll give you an example of how this might work. Yeah, take a look at my connections. Here are my three servers. I know for a fact that's a phony server. I just added that and I never tested it. That was just for testing purposes, just to demonstrate how to add a server. If I were to go in here and choose to clean up the connections, what you'll notice is that that's one of the things that we're going to remove from your known servers table. There we go. I'll go ahead and close this and now take a look at my connections. The one that we could not connect to has been purged. Now, if there had been any other things like aliases that needed to be purged, that would have been done as well.